Hi everyone, this video will review some math concepts that you'll need in this class. The concepts that we will discuss are logarithms and quadratic equations. We will discuss logarithms in the first several videos and quadratic equation in the last. Logarithms, or logs, are the inverse of an exponential function. In an exponential function, which is shown at the top, you usually have a constant, for example 10, raised to a variable power, for example x. We would call different parts of this function special names because we want to relate this to the log function later. 10 here will be called the base number, x is of course called the exponent, and y is called the argument. A log is just the inverse of an exponential function. When you write a log, you would write it as log, logarithm, the first component of that function, and then the base number would be written at the bottom, and then the argument would be written right next to the log, and that whole operation should equal to the exponent. Let's do a couple of examples to see how an exponential function relates to a log function. Here's an example of an exponential function. Y is equal to 10 to the third. What is y? If you plug this into your calculator, you get your answer, which is 1,000. Let's say you have a different question. 10 to the x is equal to 1,000. What is x? Here's where log will help you, because we have a base number and we have an argument, and what we're trying to find is the exponent. So finding the log of 1,000 with the base number 10 will give you the answer, which is x. I'm going to show you how to do this on your calculator. So if you type the number 1,000 and you type the log function, you get the answer 3, which is of course we know is the correct answer because 10 to the power of 3 is 1,000. So we can write our calculation with the following writing. Log of base 10 of 1,000 is equal to 3. Now, a log base 10 is usually just written as log. So you can also write what you wrote up here as log of 1,000 is equal to 3. Log base 10 is not that important in chemistry. A more important log function in the sciences is called the natural log. What are natural logs? It turns out that if we look at continuous growth rates of natural systems, their growth rates follow an exponential function where the base number of that exponential function is a number called e, which is equal to 2.71828. And more decimals can be given here depending on how accurate you want that number to be. What are some examples of systems that display continuous growth rates or even decay rates? Population growth is a good example of this, whether it's population of human, population of bacteria, population of animals. Radioactive decay of isotopes is another good example of this, and we would discuss some part of this in Chem 12. Compound interest calculation is another example of a system that display growth rates continuously, and then speed of chemical reaction is another thing that we would discuss in Chem 12. Whenever you have one of the following the systems that I described in the previous slide, the exponential function that you can use to describe the behavior of those systems would have the following form. Y is equal to A times e to the power of bx. In this case, A and B are constants, and x is a variable, which usually represents time. For example, let's use a compound interest calculation to show how you can use this function to calculate a final balance. Let's say your bank continuously compounds your savings account at 5% annual interest rate for 10 years, and you have an initial balance of $120. The money you'll have after 10 years can be calculated using this function y is equal to a times e to the power of bx, where y is your final balance. The different components of this function are given in the question. So a is actually the initial balance of your savings account, b is the annual interest rate that you're getting, which is 5% and normally is written as 0.05, and like I said earlier, x is usually a representation of time, so in this case 10 years is what the value of x is. If you plug in all of those numbers, you should get 197.85 cents, as the final balance of your savings account if you were to put $120 at the beginning and leave it in there for 10 years with a 5% annual interest rate. You want to keep this exponential function form in mind, y equals a times e to the power of bx, because you'll see it a few times in Chem 12 when we discuss different topics. This is very important. Now, we discussed about natural log earlier. What is a natural log? A natural log is written as ln, which stands for natural log, and this is basically a log with a base number e. So when I write log with base number e of a certain argument that's equal to a particular exponent, that is a natural log. A lot of times this would just be written as ln of the argument equals to the exponent. Going back to our calculator, you can see that ln and e are inverse functions of each other. So this is the exponential form, this is the logarithmic form. You want to try to do this in your calculator so you get comfortable with switching back and forth between the exponential form and the logarithmic form. So there's four questions here, they're fairly straightforward, you just need to type them into your calculator. What is e equal to, what is e to the power of 3, what is ln of 20.086, what is ln of 3, and what is e to the power of 1.0986. I'll do a couple of these to show you how to do it. So our first question is, what is e to the power of 3? You can see that e is the inverse function right here, so I'm going to type 3 and then inverse that function, which will take me e to the power of 3, and you can see the answer here is 20.086. Let's do our second question, which is, what is the ln of 20.086? Now, because ln is the inverse function of the e function, we should get 3 as our answer. If this is 20.086, I type ln, I get 3. So in other words, you can see that the e to the power of x and ln is exactly inverse of each other because we get the same exact answer. You should go ahead and try all of these in your calculator, and you'll find that you should get all of these as your answers. Another example would be to try the compound interest calculation that we did earlier. Again, the values that you would enter are 120 and then e to the power of 0.05 times 10. And what you should get in the end should be $197.85.